Good morning, children. Here, myself, Padma Dikshitan, taking science. So, children, welcome to the class of science. And as you know, children, we are studying chapter number 12, and the name of the chapter is Air, Water, and Weather. And in this chapter, children, we have already learned about air. And in today's class, children, we are going to know something more about water. As you know, that children, we need water to live. And all the living beings on the earth, as well as all the other living things on the earth, need water for their survival, such as the plants, the animals, and the human beings. So, all you should be knowing in what kind of how much water you are needing for your own body. Secondly, you will be knowing in this topic, with the help of this topic, that how to remove the some of the impurities present in water. As you know, children, the natural sources are available of water around you. But do you think that kind of water which is available in the water bodies is suitable for you to drink? Well, the answer is no. You cannot drink that water which is present in all the water bodies around you, as it is not pure. It is full of germs and full of impurities. So once when you need to drink any water, first thing which you need to do is make the water suitable for drinking. And it should be free of germs, it should be free of impurities. So in all, you should remember that only clean water and pure water is suitable for you to drink. As if you drink this impure water, which is full of germs, definitely you will fall sick. You will fall ill. And for you to know, in today's class, we will know one simple method how to make water suitable for drinking. And in today's class, you will know more about water. So children, let's begin our class and try to understand something more about water which you don't know, as it is a new thing for you to learn in today's class. So children, more than 2/3 of the earth's surface is covered with water. Something new for you to learn, children, remember. More than 2/3 of the earth's surface is covered with water. You know, the earth is having water in the form of various water bodies. So, you can understand 2/3 of the earth's surface is covered with water. And in the form of water bodies such as seas, oceans, rivers, lakes and ponds. These are the various water bodies present on the surface of the earth. Children, a large part of the water is also locked up as snow on the mountains. As you see, at some polar regions, the mountains are covered with snow. At very cold places, the mountains are covered with snow. So, when this snow is melted, it is converted into water. And they are coming down in the form of rivers. So you can understand, even the snow is in the form of water only. So you can say a large part of water is also locked up as snow on the mountains. So it is a form of solid state of water in the form of snow. Children, water exists in three states in nature. First state, children, we should remember, solid state as snow, liquids as water, and gas as vapor. You should remember, children, there are three states of water. One is solid, the other one is liquid, and third one is gas. So, in all, when you need to know the solid state of water, you can say it is ice or snow. Then, in the form of liquid, you can say it is water. And then, when you want to see the water in the form of gas, it is known as vapor. Clear? As for you to understand, I have made some diagram here. And in this diagram, you are going to know how the vapor can be formed. When you boil water, children, here, children, I am heating the water with the help of a burner. I have put some water in this container. And as the heat is provided to the container, the water is getting boiled. And once the water is boiled, the water is giving out vapors. You must have observed at home, at times something is boiling on the gas, you are always watching the vapor coming out of that container. So this is the formation of vapor, which is changing water into vapor. Children, second example which I have given you is the ice. I have kept a glass full of water which is having ice cubes in it. And children, this ice cubes after some time are going to melt. And then it is taking the complete form of water. So once the ice is solid, then it is changing into water after melting. So it is changing into liquid. When ice is there, it is in the form of solid. And when ice is melting, children, it is forming liquid, that is water. So you can see the three states of water, children. Once I have shown you the ice, that is the solid state of water. Then the ice is changing into liquid and it is changing into water. So this is the liquid state of ice. Then we have come to know about the water which is getting heated and it is getting vapor after a boiling point. And then it is changing into gas. So these are the three states which you have learned, children. So you can say water can easily change from one state to another by heating or cooling it. What have you understood, children, by this experiment? With the help of this experiment, children, you have understood that water can easily change from one state to another by heating or cooling it. There are the two states. Once it is heated, the other one it is cooling. So in all, I hope you have understood the three states of water. With the help of solid, you have understood that it can be ice. Then when it is liquid, it is water. Then when it is gas, it is vapor. Clear, children? So moving ahead, children, let us learn which water is suitable for drinking and how we can make water suitable for drinking and how much water you should be consuming for your own body. Children, we should drink at least 8 to 10 glasses of clean water every day. Please make it sure, children, and make a habit of drinking 8 to 10 glasses of water in a day for keeping a healthy body. To stay healthy, you remember this? Please try to make a resolution that you will drink at least 8 to 10 glasses of water in a day and thus you will maintain a healthy body. Clear? And share this knowledge with your friends and family also, which I have told you today in my class. Children, unclean water contains germs that can cause diseases. As I have told you in my class today, that all water bodies are not having water suitable for drinking. As it is not clean, it is containing some germs in it. So children, tap water can contain many germs, mud, sand and other impurities in it. And these things which are present in water which are not suitable for drink are supposed to be known as impurities present in water. So children, we can clean water at home and make it fit for drinking and cooking. How we can do it, children? Let us learn with the help of this. We can do so in many ways. First way which I am going to tell you today in my class is, children, it is boiling. Very simple method of making water suitable for drinking and free of germs. And that is, children, boiling. What you need to do is, children, boiling water for about 10 to 15 minutes kills germs present in it. And once boiled, drinking water should be kept in clean and covered container. Always remember, this is the simplest method which you can do and make the water suitable for drinking, as boiling water for 10 to 15 minutes will kill the germs present in water. Clear, children? Remember this, okay? And then when it is boiled, you should keep it in a covered container. And when it is kept in a covered container for some time, it is cooled. And after cooling, it can be suitable for you to drink that water, as it is free of germs. So I hope, children, in today's class you have learned quite things, like what the first point was, children, that you have learned that the 2/3 of the earth's surface is covered with water. Remember, children, and the water bodies which are there on the surface of the earth, those are seas, oceans, rivers, lakes and ponds. But this water is not suitable for you to drink. Remember this. Then children, I have taught you about the three states of water. That water exists in three states in nature, such as solid in the form of snow. Then you have learned liquid in the form of water. Then children, the gaseous form, that is the vapor. And children, you have learned that water can easily change from one state to another by heating or cooling, as I explained you with the help of this experiment here. Clear? As the ice is melting, before when it is in the form of ice, it is solid. And when the ice is melting, it is forming liquid, that is water. And then this water is boiled and the vapors are coming out after some time when the water is boiled. So this is making a change in the three states of water. Then children, you learned that you should drink 8 to 10 glasses of water in a day to maintain a healthy body. Then finally children, you have learned that some impurities are present in water and those are not suitable for you to drink. Clear? And to make some impurities out of the water, you should do one method which is simple to make the water pure for drinking, that is boiling. That is only possible if you boil water for 10 to 15 minutes and it will kill the germs present in water. And then cover, put it in a covered container and let it cool for some time. And that water is suitable for you to drink. So I hope children, with the help of this today, you have learned the kind of activity which I have told you. And with the help of this experiment, I have told you which all water is suitable for you to drink. And in further class children, we are going to learn many more methods which will be suitable for you to make the impurities out of the water. And we will learn in the next class about those methods. Clear children? So children, try to go through the video and try to understand the topic properly. And again I am giving you the message that save each and every drop of water in your own house and try to save the water as it is going to run short on the earth. And we need water for our survival and all the other living things also need water for survival. So water is very, very necessary for us. Clear children? So giving this message and a good note, and I hope you will follow and circulate this message around everywhere to save water as much as you can. And always try to drink clean water, and which is making your body healthy, which is helping you to make your body healthy. Never drink unclean water as it is full of germs and it is full of impurities. So always make it sure that you drink clean water. Dear children, so go through the video and try to understand my topic which I have explained you, and just save each and every drop of water around you. Clear? Don't waste water. So thank you for now children. That's all for the class today. Have a nice day. Bye bye.